is Alex McIntosh. That was the Circus Bee conducted by Tony Gorley. Tony, come out. Tony is a student teacher who's been with us this whole semester from Mount St. Joseph. Everybody give Tony a hand. He has been a very valuable asset, not only to me, I'm pretty sure I speak for the other directors as well, just having him in class, having him being able to, you know, teach the kids and educate the kids in a different capacity than, you know, maybe us older guys, or especially those older guys are used to. Just been, like I said, a really great help and a great asset. So, yeah, thank you, Tony. Really nice job. Really nice having you. The next and final piece we'll be playing is a piece called All of Me. It's by, if you're familiar with the YouTube channel Piano Guys, it's actually a piece that was written for piano by the gentleman who's in charge of that music group, John Schmidt, which I personally arranged for this ensemble. So this is All of Me by John Schmidt, arranged by Alex McIntosh.
As we're finishing up the setup here, I want to acknowledge the fact that you are a part of history right now, and you are attending the last band concert in this auditorium as you know it. After June 2nd, there's a meeting June 2nd, then we'll find out the exact demolition date, and they are taking this place down to the bare walls. Everything's coming out. Sound, lights, everything. So, yeah. When we're done tonight, I'll turn on all the lights for you. Oh, wait, they're already all on. Yeah. I'll let you take some pictures. But seriously, the central office administration and the boosters have gone way, way further than I ever imagined this would go. And the auditorium and the gymnasium are both going down to cinder block. I mean, they're even taking the paint off. I mean, everything's going to be new. New bleachers, new paint, new floor, new carpet, new seats, everything. So we're experiencing a bit of history here tonight. And a little nostalgic, but I had someone ask Mr. Greenwood at the meeting the other night if they could have seats, and I don't know how that works, but there will be big dumpsters sitting around the building before long, so if you're a dumpster diver, go for it. So, but I didn't tell you that. So, all right, you guys ready? All right, this is the Jazz Ensemble. We're going to play four selections for you. Sit back and enjoy. We do have a program switch here. We're going to start with Joe Garland's In the Mood. Saxophone, Joey, stand up. Andy McGuire, an alto saxophone. Yeah, let's hear Randy. Brandon Minner on trumpet. All right, before I start our next selection, since that one obviously very, very percussive, dominated piece of music as far as anything Glenn Miller, if you don't have a good set player, you're not going to do it. Tim Jones, our drum set player, waved him, along with Brandon Minner. Wave, Brandon, since he just soloed. Wave, so people know who you are. Wave. There you go. In a couple weeks, we'll be on the stage at Millett Hall, both as Sumas for the class of 2014. So give them a round of applause. So very, very proud. This is a very intelligent group of children. Obviously, we've talked about Brody earlier this year as a commended national merit finalist, semifinalist. So, and then you have, you know, ironically enough, a really, really, really intelligent group of people. A lot of people think jazz musicians are not intelligent. These are the smartest kids in the whole school right here. So I feel pretty lucky. So, yeah. All right. Next, we're going to utilize a little bit. Sorry, I should not be sitting down and talking to you. Utilize a little bit more of Mr. Gorley's expertise this semester has been the fact that he has extensive work in African, Brazil, ethno drumming. And so we've talked a little bit about that, mainly in percussion ensemble. But this last piece with them, he was able to do a little bit more with it than just teach the notes and the rhythms and how it's supposed to go and so on and so forth. So, featuring Chicoria Spain, I'll introduce Mr. Tony Gorley and the jazz band.
Thank you.
percussion is finishing up changing parts back there. I want to just remind you, this is the high school concert band. They are comprised of students from grades 9 through 12. This is a non-audition ensemble. All they do is audition for chairs once they get in there and per period, and then we put them together and mix them up and start all over, and it's a fun group. Mr. Greenwood and I were just talking about how far they've actually come this year musically, maturity-wise. There's several of these students who will be moving on up to the upper wind ensemble next year, and very, very proud of that. That's what's supposed to happen. And some of them choose to stay right where they're at. They're comfortable. They're playing what they want to play, and that's awesome as well. So could be prouder of it. All these kids, they've done a great job all year, and their journey this year has come a long way, and we're going to finish it this year with a pretty difficult piece of music written by the former director at Miami University, Dave Schaefer. And this is Journey into Diablo Canyon. As soon as they're finished, we'll do another quick change, and then we'll have our last ensemble of the evening.
Thank you.
For our final ensemble this evening, I would like to present the Colerain High School Wind Symphony. This is, once again, grades 9 through 12, and they are students who have a little bit more natural ability than I do, or they practice a lot more than most of us, or they take private lessons, or the a myriad of things make them be in this ensemble over the other ensembles, and just a different type of literature. But still just a really good high school concert band. So their first selection is a wonderful collection of tunes from the ever-popular Wizard of Oz. This is arranged by James Barnes, who was the director of bands at Kansas for many, many years, did a lot of awesome things. And there's even a very appropriate tuba solo right in the middle. So I'd like to introduce Mr. Tony Gorley and the Colerain High School Wind Ensemble.
Thank you.
while they're finishing tuning back there. The next piece is what musically you would call a tone poem. And what a tone poem is it's going to tell you a story, and it's going to take you through a journey. One of the biggest black eyes on this country was in 1838, under the presidential leadership of Andrew Jackson, no relation, I'm sure, to our current superintendent, but under his leadership, he ordered the federal troops to drive all the Native Americans from their land, and that became known as the Trail of Tears. What you're about to hear is that painful and mournful journey where more than 4,000 people lost their lives a day, and for the first few days, and then it trickled down, very hard winter. And you will hear everything from the bugle calls to people moaning, people mourning, Native American speaking. So I hope you enjoy our presentation of Trail of Tears, and something very different for you. As we begin to close our program for this evening and for our last performance in here, I want to encourage you to keep an eye open for the fall. We have gone back to scheduling an October concert. Last year we did not do that because we were starting a new testing process with the kids, you know, the pre and post test, and we didn't know what it was going to entail. And during marching band season, I wasn't going to put any more work on the three of us than I had to. It really wasn't that big of a deal. So we're going to go back and start doing our October concert again. It'll be a Pops concert. And I have a really good feeling that this place won't be done yet. So I've already scheduled it off campus. And it's going to be secret until October. It is a very nostalgic place. And I'll tell you where it is in October. I want to thank you guys all for coming out this evening. I encourage you to look through that program. Lots of useful information in there. Encourage you to make sure you log into Charms. Check out the band calendar and the band website throughout the summer. I hope you have a great summer, safe summer. And encourage you to keep the horns on the faces. Even if you're going on vacation, the mouthpiece buzzing or whatever, or just listening to music will make them stronger every day. So thank you for a great, great year. And we're going to close out our program this evening with John Phillips' Put Your Hands Across the Sea. Thank you.
Copies of this program are available for $20 each. Send program title, along with your address and check or money order, to Waycross Community Media. Attention Dub Coordinator, 2086 Waycross Road, Forest Park, Ohio, 45240. Or buy securely on the web at www.waycross.tv.